How to overclock your Raspberry Pi. In this video, I will show you how to overclock your Raspberry Pi using a simple web-based tool. You'll need to know which Raspberry Pi model you have and how to edit a text file on your Raspberry Pi. That's it. No further knowledge is required. Head on over to PiCockpit.com, click on blog, and overclock your Raspberry Pi in the Raspberry Pi Tools section. This page contains the web-based tool you need to get started with reasonable overclocking settings. First, select your Raspberry Pi model. Let's say I have a Pi 400, so I select the Pi 400. Click on Next Step. Now you'll see a screen asking you to select how much you would like to overclock your Raspberry Pi. You've got a choice between medium booster and maximum performance here. The medium booster one is the best choice for most people, so let's go with it. Click on Next Step. Now you'll get an overclock preset recommendation tailored to your Raspberry Pi. Click on the Download button to obtain a text file of these settings. Now we need a file manager with root rights in order to copy the file into the boot partition. Click on the Raspberry Pi menu icon and select Run. Type in sudo pcmanfm and press Enter or click OK. You'll see a little indicator icon showing you you are in super user mode. Click on Boot. Now drag and drop the overclock.txt file into the boot partition. Check that it's really there. Next, locate the config.txt file. Open it by double-clicking on it. Locate the All line at the very bottom of this file. Now add include overclock.txt in a new line at the very bottom of a file. Save the file and close the editor. Before rebooting, we'll check the current maximum clock speed using PiCockpit. In PiStats, you can see the current CPU load and SoC temperature. PiDoctor shows you the current CPU frequency and voltage. Note the values of 1800 MHz and the current CPU voltage 0.9500 volts here. Also check the undervoltage, arm frequency cap and throttling indicators. Ideally, they should all be in the OK state. One last thing before we reboot. We'll install SRESNG to test the overclock stability. Open the console and type sudo apt-get update. Then write sudo apt-get install stress-ng. Run stress-ng to see the current state and the impact on the clock speed and SoC temperature. Stress-ng --CPU for --CPU -method FFT. This will run StressNG on 4 CPU cores using the fast Fourier transform method. Check the instructions on the PiCockpit.com overclocking page for more details and options. In PiStats, you'll now see a load of 100% and the SoC temperature will be slowly rising. The Pi 400 has a very good built-in aluminium heatsink, so it copes quite well with this load. Note that the CPU frequency, as seen in PiDoctor, still stays at 1800 MHz. It's the current limit on this Pi 400. We haven't rebooted it yet, so the new settings aren't active yet. Let's do it now. You can actually use PiCockpit to reboot the Pi. Go into Pi Control and click Reboot. If you don't have PiCockpit, you can of course reboot your Pi using the usual method. After the reboot, your Pi should feel a bit snappier. Let's check the current frequency situation using PiCockpit. In PiDoctor's system module, you'll see that the current CPU frequency is higher than 1800 MHz. It will go as high as 2200 MHz depending on load. In PiStats, you can check the current CPU load and SoC temperature. Let's run a stability test on the Raspberry Pi using StressNG, which we've installed before. Open the console and run stress-ng by typing stress-ng --CPU for --CPU -method FFT. This stress test will show you whether the overclock is stable or not. It should run for an hour to give you somewhat reasonable confidence in your settings. On my Pi 400, it crashes after a couple of seconds. So now I would start to adjust the CPU frequency down by editing overclock.txt. As a Raspberry Pi engineer told me on the Raspberry Pi forum, if they could have made the stock Raspberry Pi overclock rate higher, they would have done it. So your results will vary depending on the silicon lottery. One Pi might overclock fine, while another one will crash even with slightly higher CPU frequency settings. If your Raspberry Pi doesn't boot at all with the new overclocking settings, you can press the Shift key on your keyboard and keep it pressed, and then edit the settings to remove the overclock or adjust it down. Happy overclocking! And thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please share it, subscribe, and press the alert notification button below. Thank you.